Welcome back, 625 right now, and CBS 46 is your school authority as some districts continue teaching in the remote model for now.
Our Rebecca Schramm reports some community groups have formed a coalition to help struggling families keep their children on track.
I think we're doing science today.
Mother of three, Jennifer Sharon, has her hands full with remote learning, especially with 10-year-old Joey, who has Down syndrome.
No rep. He typically loves school. He can't wait. Actually, he doesn't even like the weekends because he'd rather be in school.
But with remote learning,
we're going to work on some of our vocabulary stuff.
Staring at a screen all day isn't so fun for Joey.
Some days he'll power through on things, but most days it's literally fighting with him to do every single problem.
Jennifer lost her job because of the pandemic, and it's hard to look for a new one since she has to keep Joey on task all day. Without her income, she and her husband can't afford to hire a full-time tutor. Families across the state are feeling the same struggle.
The pods that people are doing aren't really set up for our kids.
It's why several community groups are coming together urging Governor Brian Kemp to use part of the CARES Act funding to provide micro grants to low-income families or parents of special needs children. In a letter to the governor, the group wrote, "We believe that offering direct assistance to parents at this time is a necessary lifeline to help prevent those with the greatest need from falling further behind their peers."
I think that would be fabulous. It would be great to have someone come in during the school day and give us a break.
I asked Governor Kemp's office if he would consider micro grants for special needs families. A spokesman told me he is considering a broad range of proposals, including this one. In Dunwoody, Rebecca Schramm, CBS 46 News.